Hi everyone, and welcome to J7409 Weather. My name is Jewel. Today is Friday, the 24th of January, 2020, and boy, oh boy, all kind of things are going on. This is the 6-hour accumulation of snowfall. Before I get into any of this, I want to tell everyone that probably the way it's looking like, and I'll show you if things hold together. Of course, they could change. But look out, Massachusetts, because you could have a northeastern coming your way by the first week of February. And I'm talking, there's probably going to be more snow. And this is for the Boston area, more snow than you've had all year. All of this and more is going to be coming up on. We also have a small chance of some tornadoes breaking out today. I've got so much stuff to show you. Please watch this entire video. Now, this is the 6-hour accumulation snowfall rate from the GFS. I'll show you on the more colored GFS later on, plus this weekend's forecast. But right now, I just want to show you this right quickly as we move through. Now, the snow that's happening right now, this is like lighter snow. You can see 2 inches, 1 inch moving on across. Nothing really significant, except a lot of mess with the ice and the rain that is bringing through as it tracks on through. But as we move on up in time, you can see what's going to happen. Now, we should have some ice this weekend for the most part over in Maine for the highest probability of ice. But as we move through, this is just showing snow. Snow. Now we're down to the end of the month, the 30th right here. See a little bit of snow coming up here in Oklahoma. Well, that's not a little bit. That's 7 inches. Right on the borderline of Oklahoma and Kansas. We do have some over in portions of Idaho, small amounts. But we're going to have a system that pulls up out of this area, and it's going to have a lot of vorticity in it, and that's going to bring a lot of snow. So let's keep on moving around. Now, you don't see that low, but I'm telling you it's there. Look over for my Canadian friends right in this area. 14 inches, 11 inches of snow. You can see this lighter snows down around the Appalachian Trail, moving up into West Virginia, parts of Pennsylvania, New York. But now look, now this isn't the most of it, but I'm just telling you, places in northern New Jersey, I don't think New York City will get that much right now, maybe 2 inches, a little farther to the west, 4 inches. Connecticut, Rhode Island, all you guys, this is 4 inches of snow right in these areas. It moves up into Vermont, New Hampshire, and portions of Maine. But as it moves up, look at this. This is snow. This is not ice. And over in these areas here, a foot of snow is possible. Right around the coastlines moving into, and this would include Boston right in here, a foot of snow. This is up on the 2nd of February. Doesn't mean it's going to happen. But if this low that I show you after a few moments materializes and moves up, there is a good possibility. Only time will tell, but I need to let you know now because this is going to be the most snow that you guys have had all year. Now we're checking out the NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Of course, this is the GFS NAM map. Now, you're going to see this is going to go through the weekend, and it's going to look like a whole lot of ice up in Maine. There's going to be, but before I turn this on, the southern part of Maine, I think, this is my forecast. You're going to get snow, you're going to get sleet, you're going to get rain, and it could be very heavy at times, but I think that your temperatures are going to hover just above freezing, and this is going to cause all the stuff that you get to have little accumulation. But as you move a little more northerly into the west of Maine, you're going to get pounded. So let's just turn this on, let it roll, and let me get this going so you can see what's going on. Now, lighter snow, as you can see, Missouri, Iowa, Wisconsin, a little bit of Maine there as the system moves through. But there's sure going to be no shortage of active weather in the eastern U.S. for this weekend. Now, this low pressure system's going to slowly advance towards the east with periods of snow. That's going to be most common in the Midwest and the Great Lakes, where you could accumulate several inches of snow. It's going to make a mess traveling, though. The conditions are going to be hazardous to travel in parts of these areas for today. Now, as the storm pushes east late today, so will the shield of precipitation, which will encounter low-level cold air in parts of the central and northern Appalachians tomorrow morning. Now, what's that going to do? Well, it's going to snow. The precipitation's going to fall in the form of snow and freezing rain from northern Pennsylvania early tomorrow to northern New England tomorrow night. Now, over a tenth of an inch of ice accumulation is possible in the very higher elevations of the Northeast, with a couple of inches of snow also in play. Now, expect snow showers to linger around the Great Lakes into Sunday morning. The I-95 corridor will look to remain mostly for rain during the duration of this storm. To the south, heavy rain's going to be a concern as rainfall totals as much as 1 to 2 inches, with locally heavier amounts. They can be expected in the Virginia Blue Ridge areas, and also on south to the Smoky Mountains later today. Now, these rain rates may be high enough to generate some flash flooding in portions of the central Appalachians and over the Virginia and Maryland Piedmont this evening and night, also going into tomorrow morning. Need to pay attention now. The plume of moisture associated with the system then should advance north and east for tomorrow into the Northeast, with heavy showers and breezy conditions along the Mid-Atlantic and Northeast coast. Most locations neighboring the I-95 corridor will receive at least 1 inch of rain, with locally higher amounts. The drier conditions will arrive first in the Mid-Atlantic for tomorrow evening, while the Northeast will have to wait to dry out until Sunday morning. Now, quickly, as we switch coastlines, going out west, several rounds of heavy precipitation will continue over the Northwest into the weekend as a series of Pacific cold fronts push into the region. Heavy rain's going to be the primary precipitation type for the coastal ranges and valleys, where as much as a few inches of rain are possible. Meanwhile, Washington State and Oregon Cascades will contend with heavy snow, where snowfall totals as much as 2 feet are anticipated. And look for this active weather pattern to continue into the start of the upcoming week. Now, on the regular GFS map for the average precipitation rate, I'm going to click through and show you what I'm talking about that may occur as it's low. It hasn't formed yet, but it's going to come up from down here. It's going to bring a lot of heavy rain, and when it gets up in this area, the cold's going to dip down, and these areas could have more snow than they've had all year. Here, this is the lighter snow going on now down from parts of northern Arkansas, moving up into Missouri and Iowa and on up into Wisconsin. Now, we're just going to click through right quick. This is the system for this weekend that's coming through, bringing lots of heavy rain. And as you can see, it's looking like it's going to go right on off. And this is showing the very same thing that I just said. I think Maine, you will get ice and snow and rain. Okay, now let's move on through. Now, here's this low that is forming. This low is going to be much more powerful and have much more vorticity spin to it than the one that is going on for this weekend. As we move along, here we come. Now, watch it. It's at 1,007 right now, bringing lots of heavy rain to Florida, bringing rain to Georgia, South Carolina, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana. Now it's down to 1,001 millibars. It's strengthening, bringing snow all the way from portions of eastern Tennessee to western North Carolina up into West Virginia. This looks like lighter snow, snow in Pennsylvania, New York, but it's rain for New York City and the Long Island areas, as you can see. But just watch what happens. Look at this snow. Now, this isn't the worst of it yet, but right in this area, covering parts of Connecticut and Massachusetts, moving on up towards Maine, Vermont, New Hampshire, and this right along the coast there. Look how dark that band is, and the barometric pressure now has gone down to 964 millibars. It's going to have wind, it's going to have snow. And this is very, very heavy snow, as I showed you on the snow accumulation map. If this low does materialize and turn into what it's looking like it could, big nor'easter. This would include Boston, where on the snow map I showed you, you could get a foot of snow. Portions of Rhode Island and Connecticut, you're going to get snow too. And this heavier, heavier snow band looking like it's going to be in the southern sections of Maine also. So folks, this is just like a heads up, first week of February. If this materializes, I will keep my eyes on it. You need to pay attention, because this could be the most snow that you've had all year. And for my friends over on the West Coast up in Canada, heavy, heavy snow at the same time is going to be coming in. And wrapping it up, so far as severe weathers, when it comes to tornado possibilities, high wind gusts, downdraft winds, maybe some hail, this is what's happening. It doesn't look too bad, but we are at a 1 from Georgia's large portion of South Carolina and the coastal and Piedmont sections of North Carolina. It is at a 1. Now, we do have these showers. A few thunderstorms are expected today with these showers across the southern and middle Atlantic coastal states, and a couple of these storms could be strong. They're very possible if they form now to be strong, along with damaging winds and the chance for a possible tornado cannot be ruled out. Now, it's only at 2% chance of tornadoes down in Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina. When it comes to the wind, it's at a 5% chance of downdraft winds materializing in these very same areas. And that's a check of your weather today. Everyone stay safe. Have a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Thanks for everything you do for me, and much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for watching.